Me. Too close, Mark. You're too close, Mark. Back the fuck up. Alright. Motherfucker still on? Alright, we keeping that motherfucker in there too. I don't give a fuck. About a whole damn got the crown. Hitman Hal versus Calico. Recap. Okay. I'm gonna be honest with you. This motherfucker, this recap gonna be all over the place. Is it me, or does Hitman Holla and Calico just don't have good chemistry? It's almost like wrestling. Like, these guys just, for whatever reason, they have all the tools, the all-time greats, but when they get in the ring, on stage together, they just don't have good chemistry. Like, they just styles just don't worked. I don't know what it is. Like, it's almost like Austin, Stone Cold Steve Austin versus Undertaker. Like, outside of SummerSlam 98, like, just their matches just don't, they're not good. I don't know what it is. It just doesn't, it don't mesh well. Same thing with Hitman and Calico. Like, it just, they don't mesh well. Now, if you were in tune the way I was in tune, I was hearing different things, what was going on before the battle, so it made me actually more intrigued to see what was going to happen during the battle. But didn't really play a factor. But this is going to be a simple breakdown. It's not really going to be much of a Calico was Calico. Hitman was Hitman. This whole battle really was about who's more emotional. Hitman telling Calico, why you always playing games? Why you always joking? Calico telling Hitman, why you always emotional? Why you self-centered? That's basically what this whole battle was. Hitman Holla second round. Let's get to that real quick. I appreciate what you were doing. I appreciate the message you were trying to give, you know. Beloved Holla, I appreciate the message. Wrong messenger. That message didn't hit because it's the wrong messenger. You can't give a why you're still associating with so-and-so, why you're still in the streets, so-and-so, why you're still trying to make your name off of the streets, and then you're doing street shit. It don't work. It don't work. So I appreciate what Hitman Holla did in the second round versus Calico, but it just doesn't work, bro. It didn't work. Just type in Hitman Holla right now. That's why that second round didn't work, bro. So out of all the rounds, even though I appreciate the message, I got Calico won that second to me. Who won the first and third? I don't fucking know. Let me be honest, bro. Calico style is a hit and miss for me. I love niggas that talk that shit. It's not even no talk that shit. When you remember back in the day in the URL, you should do the strengths and weaknesses or strengths, right? And it basically still like had a young old voice, right? Calico, you should just put under Calico talks that shit. I love niggas that talk that shit, right? But with talking that shit, sometimes it's hit and miss for me, man. So like, this whole Calico was Calico. He was talking that shit, but the punches for me, you understand? Sometimes I'm like, can you just be more? Can you just give me more? Can you just do more? Hey, hey. It's just like, I just need more. I don't know. Hitman Holla. What's interesting, we didn't get a remix in this battle. he wasn't even really performing in this battle. It's like he was truly trying to prove to us and the Calico that he can rap. He can rap. He's not the best lyricist in the world. No, he's not. He's not. You're not. You're not. He's not. But he can rap, and he knows how to set up shit and how to, you know, you have, he said something to where, I have you, something to where, like, I have you pick you up off a show floor. I forget how it was set up, but, like, Hitman Holla is, what's Hitman Holla? So, it's like, I didn't get anything new from this battle. They didn't think I didn't think I was going to get from this battle. What's interesting is the one thing I thought we was going to really get a breakdown of, they barely touched the Brotherhood shit. The whole battle was based off really like the Brotherhood, and y'all didn't touch that at all. I'm not understanding. Y'all didn't talk about that shit at all. Like, at all. Y'all barely talked about it. It's just like, okay, then Hitman Holla talking about Big T. I don't know what Big T said about Hitman, but obviously he has a problem with Big T. I'm like, what? What did Big T got to do with any of this? Do a shout out Mook though. he did shoot out Mook, which I'm never mad at, because Mook has an opinion about everybody, so it doesn't matter to me. I know Mook probably is going to do an interview talking about Hitman and doing all that other shit, so I'm not even concerned about that. I don't know, man. I told you so, this battle just, it was good. It was cool. I really wanted to go and rewatch this battle again and give y'all a clear winner who I had winning. I don't care to watch that battle. That battle's like 50 minutes long. I don't care to rewatch it, re-listen to it to give you a winner. Consistency is in my heart. If I'm just going off emotion, Calico probably won that battle. Probably won that battle. What rounds? I don't fucking know. It's just the feel. I'm just giving you how I feel from that battle. It just felt like Calico won. I think Hitman spent too much time talking about other people. Here's the problem with Hitman, man. The problem with Hitman is Hitman does a lot of explaining, right? Like, he does a lot of, y'all saying I'm this, y'all saying I'm that, you saying I did this, you saying I that, but how come when I do something, but when he do something, it's like, why you keep, like, niggas, for me, it's just like, yo, why you gotta keep saying, and let me do that, y'all will be, but if I did that, it's like, nigga, just, I don't know, like, it's just, I don't know, man. It's just, I don't know. And then he said, I'm better than Mook. I'm better. Like, bro. First of all, I'm not mad at you saying you're better than Mook. We're going to be very transparent. I got shits in the work that I'm working on. I'm actually going to wait till after this week to do it. After this week, you're going to get new content that I'm working on next week. It's not going to be this week. But, like you're saying, I'm better than Mook, I'm better than Lux, I'm better than, and just like, you know, as soon as you say you're better than, people gonna start, like, but, I do find it funny that both Hitman and Cal, been saying lately, they're the GOAT, like, that's all they've been saying, I'm the GOAT, I'm better than Mook, I'm better than Lux, I'm the GOAT. Let's find it interesting. I don't know what's going on with that, but hey, all right. We gonna see. We gonna do a breakdown. Once again, look out for shit next week. But yeah, I just feel like once again, I can't give it rounds. I feel like maybe Cal second and third. I probably had Cal, but I'm not rewatching that battle. I'm sorry, I'm just not. Don't look for me to go to the Jay Black or whoever, like it really does break down. I'm just not rewatching that battle. I'm sorry. Maybe on downtime, if I have time, which shit. If you only knew the fuck shit I'm going through right now. But yeah, it just, so for all y'all that want a winner, who I have winning, I got Cal. Do I feel confident in that? No. Am I going to rewatch the battle? No. So you look for a real analysis? I'm sorry that you clicked on this. But shout out to him and shout out to Cal. Should I make a separate video or no? How much time I got? 10 minutes? Okay. That's not too bad. I'm going to make this very quick. Him and Holla. I try not to get involved in other people's business because at the end of the day, it's not my fucking business. Okay? I'm going to say this, and I'm going to leave it the fuck alone. In regards to, I'm going to talk in generalization. Hitman Holla, you are a superstar. You know that. Because you remind us, you're a superstar. You got money off of battle rap. You remind us of that, right? I'm the only one that said I've made a billion off of battle rap. That's amazing. I wish everybody could say that. And they probably should have. There was visuals of this motherfucker Holla the Don's blog he made last year where everybody fucking decided they didn't know. But anyway, that's besides the point. Hitman Holla. Being the person you are, the superstar that you are, fleas attract to shit and light. There's a lot of fleas out there that want your light. They're attracted to your light. So what does that mean? That means they're going to try to get your attention. They're going to try to get your money. They're going to try to get your fame. They're going to try to get your fortune. They're going to try to... Fleas are going to do everything they're going to try to do to get that light from you, okay? And I'm not even saying you're in the right or in the wrong. Because just because you know him and Holla don't mean whatever's going on, he's in the right or wrong. But I'm just saying, in terms of just moving around, stop letting these niggas take your light, man. So I'm going to say, they don't deserve your attention. If you got to handle shit, handle it as a man, of course. But, nigga, if you have 50 million people around you, let 50 million people around you handle that shit. You ain't even got to, it's almost like a drug analogy, nigga. Like, the biggest bosses, they don't even touch the work. They don't touch the work. They don't. It's like, nigga, I have it. Prop Joe from The Wire, nigga. I haven't been on a cell phone in years. I haven't touched. Nigga. Don't be on Twitter. That's the problem with niggas. That's why niggas have you. That's why you've been going through this shit you've been going through this past 6 months with Cassidy fans. It's like they're Cassidy fans. Why do you give a fuck about a Cassidy fan, my nigga? These niggas don't, you know, live in reality, my nigga. Let that shit go, nigga. On Twitter, like, don't respond to dumb motherfuckers on Twitter, man. Niggas are professional trolls. They want to get your attention. Most of the time, just want to say, I got Hitman Holla to actually respond to my tweet. Oh my God. That's what they want. Same thing for the niggas in the street. Whatever is going on there, once again, it's not my fucking business. But, like, nigga, these niggas want your fucking light, man. And that's what all you battle rappers. All these motherfuckers on Twitter, all these motherfuckers out in the street, all these motherfuckers, they want your life. Once again, not saying you're right or wrong. But niggas want your life. Nigga, move. Move like a true superstars do. Move how true celebrities do, man. Y'all celebrities. Move that way. So none of these motherfuckers get your attention. They don't deserve it. They don't. If you're doing funny shit, handle that. But stay off the social media. So you gotta do fucking hour blogs with fucking everything. That's the only thing. So. But, better hold it down. We got the crown.